Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Understanding VNAs Cable Loss Measurements. In this presentation, we'll provide a short introduction to measuring coaxial cable loss using vector network analyzers. All coaxial cables attenuate radio frequency signals passing through them, and this attenuation is commonly referred to as either cable loss or insertion loss. Cable loss is a function of both the length of the cable as well as the frequency of the signal passing through it. Loss generally increases linearly with increasing length. In other words, doubling the length of the cable doubles its loss. Loss also increases as frequency increases, although this is usually not a purely linear relationship. Cable loss is a key manufacturer specification. It's normally given as X dB of loss per meter or foot, and frequency-dependent loss is indicated using tables and/or graphs. Knowing the amount of power lost in a cable is very important for many radio frequency applications. Although manufacturers specify cable loss, in some cases cable loss may need to be measured. This is especially true when the cable type or manufacturer is unknown, or when cable loss is affected by connectorization, wear, damage, etc. The most common way of measuring cable loss is using a vector network analyzer, or VNA. VNAs that are intended primarily for field use are sometimes also referred to as cable and antenna analyzers. These analyzers may be either benchtop or handheld instruments. Because cable or insertion loss tends to vary significantly with frequency, cable loss measurements are usually made, and results are plotted, as a function of frequency. There are two ways to measure cable loss with a VNA. The first is a one-port cable measurement, also called an S11 or reflection measurement. Here, only one end of the cable is connected to the VNA. The other method is a two-port measurement, also called an S21 or transmission measurement. In this case, both ends of the cable are connected to the VNA. We'll cover both of these methods in this presentation, starting with one-port measurements. In one-port measurements, a source or tracking generator is used to inject a signal into a cable. The frequency of the signal is swept over a user-defined range. The far end of the cable is either left open or is terminated with a short. Either of these conditions will cause the signal reaching the end of the cable to be reflected back to the source. At the source port, the amount of reflected power is compared to the known transmitted power. Assuming the loss is the same in both directions, the total or round-trip attenuation, divided by 2, is the cable loss in dB. As mentioned earlier, the total loss of the cable is a function of both the signal frequency and the cable length. Configuring a VNA for cable loss testing involves three main groups of settings. The first is specifying the frequency range over which the tracking generator or stimulus signal is to be swept. This range should cover the frequencies for which the cable will be used, and can be entered either as start and stop frequencies, or as a center and span. Another important parameter is the number of measurement points over this span. Increasing this number will provide greater detail, but more frequency points will also increase the amount of time needed to make a single sweep. Averaging multiple frequency sweeps can be used to reduce noise and obtain a more accurate result, especially for cables with very high loss. Note, however, that increasing the number of sweeps will also increase the overall measurement time. After configuring the analyzer, we can connect the cable under test to the VNA in two different ways. It can be either directly connected to the analyzer port, or it can be connected to this port using a short, high-quality DUT cable. There are several reasons why using a DUT cable is helpful. The first is for cases when the cable under test's connector is difficult to access, such as when it terminates in an enclosure or is attached to a tower or mast. Another reason is that using a DUT cable can reduce wear and tear and/or mechanical stress on the analyzer port. The effect of this DUT cable on the measurement results can be removed by means of a process called calibration. Regardless of how the cable under test is attached, a one-port calibration is also necessary for accurate cable loss measurements. The calibration process involves sequentially attaching an open, a short, and a match or load to the location where the cable under test will be connected. These standards can be in the form of discrete standards or may be combined into a calibration T. In addition to these manually attached standards, electronic calibration units can also be used. These units switch their internal standards in and out automatically and are controlled by the attached VNA. Calibration is usually a follow the prompts process, in which the VNA will indicate which standards are to be connected, in which order, and at which times. The entire calibration process usually takes only a few minutes, with automatic calibration units tending to be much faster than using manual standards. If the cable under test will be directly connected to the VNA port, the calibration standards or unit are also connected directly to the port during the calibration process. If a DUT cable is used, then the calibration standard should be connected to the far end of the DUT cable. Doing this allows a DUT cable to be removed from or calibrated out of the measurement results. Next, let's look at some example measurement results. Here, we're looking at cable loss as a function of frequency between 1 GHz and 5 GHz, with the y-axis showing loss or attenuation in dB. This trace is typical in two ways. First, note that attenuation increases with increasing frequency. Note also that the trace has a wavy pattern or ripples that are caused by reflections. We can numerically quantify cable loss as a single number by averaging the minimum and maximum values. Here, minus 1.2 dB and minus 3.5 dB. So the single number cable loss for this particular cable would often be given as minus 2.35 dB. Two-port measurements, also called transmission or S21 measurements, are generally preferred over one-port measurements in two cases. The first is when there's easy access to both ends of the cable. And the second is when the cable has very high loss, more than about 15 to 20 dB. High levels of loss tend to produce less accurate one-port measurements. In this one-port trace, we see significant attenuation, and therefore the one-port measurement results should be viewed with caution. Making a two-port measurement of the same cable provides a more accurate and more repeatable test result. In most two-port cable measurements, the cable under test is simply directly connected to both analyzer ports. If, however, DUT cables are used to connect the cable under test to the analyzer, then a normalization should be performed to remove the influence of the DUT cables from the measurement. To perform a normalization, the two DUT cables are connected using a through. After normalization is complete, the through can be replaced with a cable under test, and measurements can be performed. Let's look at a two-port or transmission cable loss measurement using the same cable and settings that we used for the one-port measurement. We see that loss is still a function of frequency, but notice the trace has fewer ripples than the one-port measurement. This is because the cable is terminated in its characteristic impedance on both ends of the cable. Although there are many cases where attaching both ends of a cable to a VNA is not practical, two-port cable loss measurements are generally preferred over one-port cable loss measurements whenever possible. Let's end with a brief summary. All cables attenuate radio frequency signals passing through them. This attenuation is commonly referred to as cable loss or insertion loss, and increases with both length and frequency. Although there are other ways to measure cable loss, the most common and the most accurate approach is using an instrument called a vector network analyzer, or VNA. There are two ways of measuring cable loss with a VNA. The first is a one-port measurement, also called a reflection, or S11 measurement. In this case, the end of the cable is left either open or shorted, because this causes the stimulus signal generated by the VNA to be reflected back, and thus allows cable loss to be determined. Another approach is a two-port transmission, or S21 measurement. Here, both ends of the cable are connected to the VNA. One port injects a swept signal into the cable, and the second port measures the magnitude of the signal at the other end of the cable. Although this approach requires a VNA with two ports, It's generally a better choice when a cable has high loss and/or when both ends of the cable are accessible. This concludes our presentation, Understanding VNAs, Cable Loss Measurements. If you'd like to learn more about VNAs, cable measurements, or instruments from Rohde&Schwarz, please see the links in the video description. Thanks for watching.